would we not want to go ahead and lay down? If God needs me to the green pasture, why would not want to lay down in a pasture that has everything that I need? He maketh me lie down in green pastures. He leadeth me beside the still waters. Let me tell you something, church. Where God takes you, there is no rough current. There is no rough waters. There is no raging waters. In this land where God is taking you, in this place that God wants to take you in your ministry, God says, I'm going to make you lie down in green pasture, but I'm going to lead you beside the still waters, because when you're thirsty, you won't have no problem going over to the river. You won't have no problem going over to the creek. You will not have no problem going to it, because it's not raging. Because let me tell you something, a horse, a deer, or any kind of animal will not drink from a raging water because they're afraid that it might sweep them away. But isn't it something about God that God will lead you beside the still waters, that you can put your head down and you can drink from the fountain, from Emmanuel's name, that you will no longer thirst no more? This is what God is telling David. This is what God is showing David, that I am a shepherd that puts you in green pasture. Let me tell you something. If you got some dead things in your life, it ain't because of God. It's because of you. If you in some green areas in your life, but you got some dead spread out in your land, it ain't God's problem. It's your problem, because you won't let God separate you from the goats. Oh, I'm here to tell you today that you can't eat, you can't sleep, you can't stand, you can't walk in the path of unrighteousness, you can't lay down with them. But let me tell you something, if you got some dead areas in your life, it ain't because of God, because my shepherd says that he leadeth me beside the still waters, he maketh me sit down in green pastures. But if you got some dead things in your life, it's because you keep carrying them with you. Listen to this. He restoreth my soul. He leadeth me in the path of righteousness for his name's sake. Don't walk. Don't sit. Don't stand. You don't recognize that people say keep your enemies close. That's not biblical. God says don't sit. Don't stand, don't walk in the counsel of the ungodly. If you're going to walk with God, if you're going to be with God, if you're going to let God be your shepherd, God promised you one thing. He says that he will restore your soul. When your soul feels like it's empty, when your soul feels like it's about to be destroyed, but if you go to the shepherd, if you go to the one that says, I am Jehovah Rohi, I am your shepherd, I am the one that provides for you, I am the one that is Elohim, that corrects anything out of it. I am the God. If you understand that he is your Adonai, he will lead you and restore your soul in the path of righteousness. And this is what you gotta get, church. He says, for his name's sake. That should make you want to shout right there. That should make you want to shout right there. But see, it ain't on the church's name. It's not on my mama's name. It's not on my grandmother and granddaddy and on my father's name. It's not on the church name. It's not because of St. Paul Missionary Baptist. It's not because the church I grew up in, Rock Hill Missionary Baptist. It's not about anything else but God's name. For his name's sake. Do y'all realize that God has put his name down for you? That God has put his name on the line? That you will be better, you will be a perfect lamb, you will be the righteousness of Christ. God has put his name down. He says, I will put my name down as collateral that you will be the person that I meant for you to be. Oh, ears have not heard, eyes have not seen what God has in store for me. You gotta understand, I hope you realize right now that the 23rd Psalm's got nothing to do about death. It's gotta do about a relationship that you have with your shepherd. It's gotta do about a relationship that you have with your Father, which art in heaven, and how hallowed his name is. But this is when it gets good with David. Because David understands that he is my shepherd. I shall not want anything else in his place. I love this man more than I love anything else in my life. But then David gets excited and he says, yea, though I walk through the valleys of the shadows of death, I will fear no evil, for thou art with me, thy rod and thy staff comforted me. So David is recognized that as I live on this earth, this is where death resides. This is the valley of the shadows of death, but I will not fear death. I will not fear the circumstance. I will not fear anything because thou art with me. Do you understand that God exists because he's with me? Did you feel him in your heart this morning? Did you feel him when he laid you down to sleep last night? Did you feel him this week when something wasn't going right, but God stepped in right on time? Did you feel God this week? That he showed you that I am with you. I am with you. My rod and my staff shall comfort you. He prepares a table before me in the presence of my enemies, that I anointeth my head with oil, my cup runneth over. I gotta get y'all to recognize that I am says that. I prepares a table. Not only I am your shepherd, not only I'm your God, not only my rod and my staff shall comfort you, not only I'm going to lay you down in green pastures, not only I'm going to lead you beside the still waters, and even though you're walking through the valley of the shadows of death, I'm going to prepare a table for you. But I'm not just going to let you see it. I'm going to let your enemies see it as well. Isn't it something that God wants to bless you so much that he allows the enemies to see what he has? Don't you understand that God says, I am your shepherd. I am Jehovah Roha. I am Elohim. I am Jehovah Jireh. I am the Lord that provides. I'm preparing this table for you. I'm preparing a table in front of your enemies. The house you got, or the house that is about to come, I already put it on your table. Oh, your health circumstance, I already spoke about it to Jesus, that by his stripes is on the table. God is preparing your table for you. Whatever you need from him is on your table. The problem with us is that we are looking everywhere else. We're looking to our doctors. We looking to our lawyers. We looking to everybody else. But looking for God. But he is Yahweh, the God that exists before anything happens. Do you recognize that God has prepared your table for you? Whatever you want, whatever you need from him, God has a table prepared for you. He has a table that only you and him can sit. There's nobody at the table but me and God. There's nobody at the because the table is prepared for me. But it's prepared for me in the presence of my enemies. But he restoreth my soul. And it's all because for his name's sake. Do y'all know that we can't lose? We can't not lose. We cannot lose. We cannot be defeated in the battle because God's name is at stake. Do y'all realize that your children shall be saved? Listen, don't fuss at them. Don't cuss them out. Don't speak harsh words to them. That just rely on God, because at his name's sake, he says, as you are saved, so shall your whole household be saved. Oh, if you remember that when you wasn't saved, when you wasn't a child of God, when you were a sinner, your mom and daddy might have been saved, but because of the covenant that God had with your mama and your daddy, God provided salvation for you as well. Y'all realize, for his name's sake, that we can't lose. Listen to this. He anointed my head with oil. My cup ran over. He anointed my head with oil. What you gotta understand that God is not gonna take time to anoint your feet. He's not gonna take time to anoint your hands. He's not gonna anoint your arms, and he's not gonna anoint your legs. But the reason why he anoints your head, because this is the very being of where you at and where your conscience is at. Because he understands that if I can change your mind, if I can change your mind, then I can change your heart. Because see, out of the heart speaks the issues of life. The reason why you're so corrupt is not because of your mind, it's because your heart has been changed. You can't forgive somebody because your heart hasn't changed. You can't love somebody because your heart hasn't changed. So God anoints my head with oil, and it flows all over my body. He anoints my head with oil. And once he anoints me, my cup runneth over. How many of y'all want a cup that runs over this morning? How many of you want a cup from the Lord that runs over in your life? How many want God to restore you back to what he had for you in the beginning? Because what the devil has taken, he can't hold it hostage any longer, because God still has the key to it. He anointed my head with oil. My cup runneth over. Listen, surely, I need for somebody to say this morning, surely, look at your husband, look at your wife, look at your sisters and your brothers, look at anybody in the house and say, surely, goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. David understands that surely, regardless of what I go through in the valley, regardless of the table that's been prepared for me, regardless of the anointing of my head, but all, regardless that he restored my soul, regardless of his name's sake, but surely because he is my shepherd, Jehovah Rapha, surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I shall dwell in the house of the Lord forever. How many of you know that you're in the house right now? How many of you know that God got you? How many of you know that you're resting in the bosom of Abraham? How many of you know that God holds you? How many of you know that your soul is anchored in the Lord? How many of you know that he is the rose of Sharon? How many of you know that he is the lily in the valley? How many of you know that he is my rock, my salvation? Whom else should I want? How many of you know that he is my cornerstone, that when my foundation is about to fall, I look to the chief cornerstone who has established me upon the rock. I shall not fall because he is my chief cornerstone. How many of you know that he is the Lamb of life? How many of you know that he is the Lion of Judah? How many of you know that he's married, little baby? How many of you know that he is God's right-hand man? How many of you know that by his stripes I am healed? How many of you know that he got up on that third day with all power in his hand? How many of you know that God still reigns this morning? How many of you know that God will never leave us nor forsake us? How many of you know that let this mind be also in you, which is also in Christ Jesus? How many of you know that he was the last official lamb slain? How many of you know that he is Jehovah Rapha? How many of you know that he's Elohim, that he's Elyon, the most high God? How many of you know that he is El Roha, the God who sees everything? How many of you know that he is Adonai, the Lord is my master? How many of you know that he is El Shaddai, the all-sufficient one? How many of you know him as Yahweh, Jehovah, the self-existing one? How many of you know that he's Jehovah Tsidkenu, the Lord of my righteousness, Jeremiah 23:6? How many of you know that he is Jehovah Jireh, Genesis 22:14, the Lord will provide? How many of you know that he is Jehovah Rapha, Psalms 23:1, the Lord is my shepherd? How many of you know that he is Jehovah Shalom, Judges 6:26-24, the Lord is my peace? How many of you know him as Jehovah Nissi, Exodus 17:15, the Lord is my banner? How many of you know that he is Jehovah Rapha, Exodus 15:26, the Lord will heal, the Lord who heals? How many know him, Jehovah Shammah, Ezekiel 48:35, the Lord is there? How many know him, Jehovah Saba, 1 Samuel 1:3-11, the Lord of hosts? How many you know as him, Jehovah Kodiskum, Exodus 31:13, the Lord who sanctifies me? How many of you know him as your deliverer? That God exists.
before time. He has no beginning, he has no end, but Jesus says that he's the first and the last, that he is the beginning and the end, that he is the Almighty God. How many of you know that God wants to deliver you today? I'm speaking to you today because God wants to deliver us. And this is what we're going to focus on for the next 2 weeks as we end this return unto me, my children. As we look to God, as we look to him, I'm going to play this song for you, and you're going to hear it a lot in these last couple of weeks as we focus on our respect for God. That in order for God to get us where he wants to get us, we have to accept that he needs to deliver us. So listen to this song real quick, Deliver Me.
It is easy to decide still waters. You restored my soul. When you become a believer
by Donald Lawrence,
your spirit
is a Tri-City Singers.
Sometimes,
deliver me.
Soul doesn't get the notice. It has a hold in it due to things that's happened in the past, hurt, abuse, molestation. But we want to speak to you today and tell you that God wants to heal the hold in your soul. Some people's actions are not because their spirit is wrong, but it's because the past has left a hole in their soul. May this wisdom help you get over your past and remind you that God wants to heal the hole in your soul. I have my sister Leandria here. She's going to help me share this wisdom and tell this story.
Thank you.
because this is where God wants to take us. I want you to be believers of God. I want you to be believers of Him as being your shepherd. I want you to understand that God has a path of righteousness for our life that will lead us to a path of righteousness, and He will lead us by the still waters, and He will lead us to green pastures. But you have to allow Him to deliver you from the things of your life that is holding you hostage. You got to understand that God does exist. God does exist because He is the creator of all. He is Yahweh. He is the God of our salvation. He is the one that provided salvation for our lives. And we got to recognize that we cannot live without God, and we cannot live in fellowship with Him by living in sin. That the only way that we can get away from sin is confess that we are a sinner to His Son, Jesus Christ. The only way to be delivered is by accepting His Son, Jesus Christ, as your Lord and your Savior. You must confess that you are a sinner. If you are a sinner this morning and you want to give your life to Christ, you have heard God, Jesus Christ knocking at your door, because in Revelation, God tells us through His Son, Jesus Christ, that He stands at the door and He knocks. God is knocking at your heart this morning. God is knocking because He wants you to receive His Son as your personal Savior, so that He may come and be a part of your life, so that you may come back to the Father and be His child. Maybe you're saying, Pastor, I want to give my life today. I know I want to give my life today. I recognize that I am a sinner. So today, repeat after me. Say, Lord Father, Lord God, I thank You for this day. I thank You for this opportunity. I thank You for waking me up this morning. I thank You for allowing me to hear Your message today. And right now, Father, I'm asking Your Son, Jesus Christ, to come into my heart. The Bible says, Father, if I confess my sins, that You are faithful and just to forgive me of my sins. So, Jesus Christ, I'm asking You to come into my heart. Rescue me today. Cleanse me from all unrighteousness. I need for You to wash me in Your blood. I need for You to cleanse me right now, Jesus, by the power of Your resurrection. Father God, I have accepted Your Son as my personal Savior, and now I am Your child. I belong to You, and now I'm asking You to send Your Holy Spirit. Send Your Holy Spirit right now, Father, to live in me, that I may live the life that You have chosen me to live. Maybe you are backslidden. Maybe you're not doing the things that you should do. Maybe you ask God, I need deliverance today, Father. I need deliverance. I thought I didn't need deliverance, God, but I recognize today that I need deliverance from some things. I need deliverance from church traditions. I need deliverance from traditions all as well. I need deliverance from some things from my family. I need deliverance from things on my job. I need deliverance so that I may grow spiritually with You, Father. Is someone out there? You have heard the call of God. You have heard His Son. You have heard His Spirit speak through you and say you need deliverance from something. So right now, just repeat after me. Say, Father, deliver me. Father, You said, if my people who are called by my name shall humble themselves and turn from their wicked ways, today, Father, I'm turning from my wicked ways. I'm turning right now, Father. I'm turning right now, God, I'm turning. Cause see, You left God. God didn't leave You. So, Father, I'm turning. I'm turning back to You. God, this is my exodus. Relieve me from all my circumstances that have hindered me from becoming what You need me to become. This is my exodus, God, that I'm going to be about You. Lead me to the path of righteousness for Your name's sake. God, I know Your name is resting on this. And Father, I thank You that I accepted Your Son. I believe in Your Son. But now I need You to deliver me so that I may be about my Father's business. I thank You. I give You glory. I give You praise and I give You honor. In Christ's name we pray. Amen and amen. God does exist. God does exist. And this is your exodus. Listen to God this week. Hear God this week. for the things that he is about to do in your life. Hear God. God's been speaking to you. God has been telling you to make a decision. He has given you the decision in your life to make, but you don't want to make it because you're afraid to step out. But believe the God that you serve. This is your exodus. God is giving you a way out of your circumstance, but you're afraid to take that step, but he is Jehovah Roha. He will lead you by the still waters. Believe him this day. Now, by the grace of God, in the sweet communion of the Holy Spirit, that shall rest and abide and rule in us forevermore, all together let the church say amen, amen, and amen. And be blessed this week as we celebrate 106 years of St. Paul Missionary Baptist Church existing this year. 106 years as of September 8th. To God be the glory for the things that he is doing and the things that he's about to do in our lives and the things to come. I thank God today that we have existed for 106 years about his kingdom and kingdom agenda that we shall do in 2020 for his name's sake. We thank him. We give him glory. In Christ's name we pray. Amen and amen. Be blessed this week. May God bless you. May heaven smile upon you. And just know that this is your exodus. Amen and amen. Be blessed.